Important mission: the C-5 Galaxy first flew on June 30, 1968, and immediately began flying the Trans-Pacific route from California to Southeast Asia, supporting the Vietnam War. In 1973, the C-5 was the backbone of emergency air deliveries to Israel, which was attacked by a number of countries. The airlift, dubbed Operation Nickel Grass Nickel, saw the C-5 fly for the first time non-stop 10 hours, with the first aircraft delivering 194,000 pounds of supplies over the course of 145 sorties. The C-5 flew a total of 21,600,000 pounds of supplies, including tanks and helicopters, to America's main ally. The C-5 flew cargo during the Cold War, specifically to Europe for NATO's annual drills. In 1990, participated in air and sea lift operations in support of Operation Desert Shield, an effort to protect Saudi Arabia from Iraq. Several months later, C-5 participated in Operation Desert Storm to liberate Kuwait from Saddam Hussein's grip. Both of these campaigns involved the largest aircraft in history. In addition to Desert Storm and Desert Shield, the C-5 participated in military and peacekeeping operations in the Balkans, Haiti, and Panama. After the 9/11 attacks, C-5s transported cargo to neighboring Afghanistan, and then to Afghanistan itself once the appropriate airfields had been secured. The C-5 frequently accompanies American presidents, carrying presidential motorcade vehicles before Air Force One. The C-5 can carry spaceships. The Air Force converted two C-5As into C-5CS, modifying them to carry space containers that carried satellites and other payloads safely. The C-5C can also carry the entire Atlas IIA rocket and parts of the International Space Station. Galaxy has also flown to Antarctica. In 1989, C-5s flew to McMurdo Airfield in support of Operation Deep Freeze, the U.S. government's annual supply of scientists studying the frozen continent. The C-5 carries 72 people and 84 tons of cargo, including two UH-1 and Huey helicopters. Launching missiles, this Lockheed Super Heavy transport was even at one point evaluated as a launch vehicle for intercontinental ballistic missiles. In 1974, the 014 aircraft carried the 43-ton Minuteman I missile. The Minuteman I is normally stored and launched from a silo complex in the Midwest, but the Air Force is investigating alternative base schemes. At some point, someone asked, "What if we could launch Minuteman I not in a silo, mounted on the ground, but in an airplane flying over the United States?" On October 24, 1974, at 20,000 feet over the Pacific Ocean, 014 opened its rear cargo door and a long, slender missile shot out. The plane shook. The crew described it as similar to dumping a cart full of water. A parachute slows the missile's fall and then the rocket fuel motor fires, sending the nuclear missile soaring into the clouds. The Galaxy C-5 also supports secret programs. The world's first purpose-built stealth aircraft, the HAV Blue demonstrator aircraft, was flown from Lockheed's Burbank, California facility in the middle of the night and whisked away for flight tests in the Nevada desert. The C-5 can transport the entire aircraft without disassembling it. More modern aircraft, perhaps the wildest version of the Galaxy C-5, never showed up. The L-500 was envisioned as a civilian aircraft with room for an astonishing 844 passengers, 50% more than the current Airbus 380. But as a military aircraft, the C-5 was built for performance, not affordability and fuel efficiency. And the plane would be too expensive to fly as a commercial jet. Despite interest from major airlines, the L-500 ironically dropped out of the civilian market and was outpaced by the Boeing 747, which the Galaxy overtaken in the military market. Despite its limited commercial capabilities, the Galaxy C-5 remains going strong half a century after its first flight. Although it is no longer the largest aircraft in the world because it lost to the Antonov An-225 Maria, there are still 56 C-5s that can still fly. Many of these aircraft have been upgraded to C-5M standard with new F-138 commercial engines with increased power, fuel efficiency, and improvements, LCD cockpits, new autopilot systems, GPS navigation, and inertial navigation systems, all-weather flight control systems and instruments, new flight instruments and engines, The C-5 is a very large aircraft with a large historical role and has become a representation of American military power. The C-5M Super Galaxy is projected to remain in service until at least 2040, at which time there will be demand for a newer, possibly even larger aircraft.
My role today was driving the commander's JLTV onto the C-5, loading and unloading operations. I really enjoy working with the Air Force. They're very well-rounded. They know what they're doing. It's nice getting to train with them, getting us proficient at loading and unloading, also helping them out, getting better at their job. It's important for us to train on this in case, God forbid, we needed to have a rapid response team to deploy somewhere, or whether that's for war or for a peacetime like mission or peacekeeping mission. It's good for us to have this knowledge and be proficient at it so that we can respond as quickly as possible.